A bold government plan to help fix the city's bus crisis could lead to traffic chaos for motorists. Police reporter Adam Todd joins us live from Grenfell Street. Adam, just what has the government got planned?
Well, Beck, buses will get a dedicated lane all the way along Grenfell and Curry Streets from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. with the aim of cutting travel time by 3 minutes. And while that's good news for motorists, it means there'll be just one right-hand lane left for cars.
This is what one of the city's busiest thoroughfares will look like in just over a month. Grenfell and Curry Streets transformed with a dedicated bus lane, sidelining cars to just one lane each way. The move in response to recent bus chaos.
We consistently have our bus companies saying Grenfell Curry Street is a problem. Every bus service is late going through the city.
Costing $200,000, the changes will be paid for by the proceeds of fines handed out to tardy bus operators. Journeys will be up to 3 minutes quicker by bus, but motorists fear the one-lane bottleneck will only add to their travel time.
If you take one, that means there's one lane for the cars. It would be a headache here in the city.
I'll probably end up taking a different route.
The government insists it isn't anti-car.
We're not just helping buses here, we're also helping motorists because we are creating a lane for them that is dedicated to motorists only.
Long-suffering bus passengers welcoming anything that cuts travel times.
Be great.
Well, it should be all right, it should work all right.
The changes, essentially a scaled-down version of a scrapped federal government plan to extend the Oban with dedicated bus lanes from Hackney Road.
And if it has the desired effect, it's something that we might consider extending to other areas of the city.
But the opposition says it's a band-aid approach.
I think what they need is a proper and cogent transport plan for the whole of the city, one that includes public transport and buses in particular.
Now, it's worth pointing out, according to the government's figures, 800 buses use this stretch every day, compared with 10,000 cars. And with one lane each, it's pretty clear buses will do much better out of this plan than cars will. Now, in addition, some right-hand turns and U-turns will be banned, and the City Council is investigating possible changes to on-street parking. All of these changes will be in place from the start of July. And if you'd like to have another look at the plans and tell us what you think, log on to our Facebook page at facebook.com/10Adelaide. But for now, it's back to you, Beck.
Thank you to our political reporter, Adam Todd.